Good morning, students. In my last video, I had taught you about the verbs and verbs in terms of the actions, various actions done by people, done by animals, birds and insects. Okay. Now in this video, I'm going to concentrate on grade 3 grammar. The topic is verbs, but this time it is verbs that do not show actions. Okay. Now those verbs are known as be verbs. Okay. They are is, am and are. That is the topic of our today's study, lesson number 13, is, am and are. Now, these words is, am and are the be verbs. These be verbs are also known as auxiliary verbs. Now, the meaning of the word auxiliary means helping. So that means auxiliary verbs means helping verbs. Okay. These auxiliary verbs or the be verbs, they do not show any action. The last video that I recorded, I taught you only about the action words. Okay, verbs that show only actions. But these verbs, they do not show any action. Okay, they are known as auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary meaning helping verbs. And they are also known as be verbs. Okay. Now these be verbs, they are used along with nouns and pronouns. Okay, now let us have a quick recap again to tell you that nouns are the names of people, names of places, names of animals, things, birds, insects, all the names. And pronouns are the words that are used in place of nouns. Pronouns function in the absence of nouns. Okay. So these be verbs, they are used along with nouns and pronouns to imply just the state of being. Because that thing is there, it is known as a state of being. Like for example, the first be verb is am, A-M-M. It is used only with the pronoun I. You will not find A-M-M with anything, with any other pronoun. You will find it only exclusively with this pronoun I. Okay. We will look at the example of A-M-M. Okay. Like for example, I am a swimmer. Okay, because it implies my state of being a swimmer. I am a swimmer. It is the state of me being a swimmer. So in this case, I am is a verb. Okay, be verb. Am is a verb in here. I am sorry. This is my state of being sorry. So here the verb is am, A-M-M. I am sorry. This is my state. And this is a be verb here. Okay. Now next example is I am writing a book. Now here the action is I, writing, done by the pronoun I. This am is helping the main verb here. Just as I said that auxiliary verbs, be verbs also help the main verbs. They are helping verbs. In this the main verb is writing and this am is helping the main verb am. So in this case, the verb is am writing. Okay. I am tired. Now here, no action is there, but this is a state. I am tired. This is my state of being tired. So here, the verb is am. I am tired. Okay, where the auxiliary be verbs are helping the main verbs, both are verbs. In case there is no action, no main verbs, this is a be verb here. Okay, am, am. Now next be verb is, is, is. Now this be verb is used with singular pronouns like he. He is used in the place of males. Okay, she is a pronoun used for females. It is a pronoun used for animals and things. This to indicate that, and for all the singular nouns. So these are the pronouns, singular pronouns, and with the singular nouns, single one. Okay, now let us look at the example. He is a cricketer. Okay, now this is a state of being a cricketer. He is a pronoun. So the state of being a cricketer is the be verb here, is. Okay, she is a tennis player. This is a state of being, the state of being tennis player. Pronoun she is a female. Okay, this female is a tennis player. This is a state of being. So the be verb is. Here the verb is. Here the verb is. Okay, verb is. Now next, it is an orange. This is a state of being. Okay, this is a fruit, the state of being a fruit. So is, it is an orange. It is used for things, for fruits, for animals and things. And he and she, singular pronouns. Okay, this box is heavy. Okay, now the state of being heavy is a be verb, is. Here the verb is. Okay, next, that is a bird flying in the sky. Okay, now flying is the main verb here. This is a helping verb here, is. Because we are pointing to a bird that is flying in the sky. Okay, the main verb is flying, and here is a be verb. That is. Sam is a tall boy. The state of being a tall boy, because Sam is a tall boy, this is his state, and here the verb is. Now next auxiliary verb is are. Be verb are. Okay, are is a plural form, is used with plural nouns. They are used with plural nouns. Plural means many. Plural means many. Okay. Plural means many. Just like we. We is a plural pronoun. You. There. You, it can be used with singular as well as plural. Like I taught you in the pronouns video, that this pronoun you can be used when we have to imply it in case of singular pronoun as well as in case of plural pronouns. There, these, and those. So these are the words with which we use this be verb are. Okay, now let us look at the examples. We are friends. Because we are friends, this is our state of being friends, and because we are more in number, we are not singular, so the verb here is are. Okay, you are in Shimla. Here the pronoun is single one. Okay, just like I told you that you can be used in case of singular pronoun also, and when the people are many, at that time also you can use the pronoun you. But here in this case the pronoun is one. We are implying to one person, so you are in Shimla. This is a state of being in Shimla, so the auxiliary verb is are. There are four cats in the basket. Mini cats, plural form. Okay, what is the state of being? The state of being in the basket. Okay, this is a be verb here. The state of being in the basket. These are wet clothes. Many clothes, plural form. Okay, the state of being wet. Okay, and that means this is a verb here. Are, these are, there are, we are, you are. Okay, next example. Those birds are flying south. Now in this, the action, main action is flying. This is a main verb. This is a main verb. Now this is a helping verb, and helping what? Helping the main verb flying. Because the birds are many, plural form. Okay, and the helping verb to the main verb flying. So here the be verb is are. Your coat and cap are pretty. Two things, plural. Okay, state of being pretty. No proper action actually, but it is the state of being pretty. So the verb is are here. Okay, that's all for today. Bye and have a nice day.